So SeaPerch means a lot because not only is it like technological and it adds, you know, a STEM part that I really didn't know that 4-H had, because I'm a livestock kid. I grew up in the barn. And so when I had my extension agent tell me about SeaPerch, I was like, well, that sounds like so much fun. So SeaPerch is just something that I really enjoy to do. It shows the diversity that 4-H has.
There was no like real tutorial on how to program this robot. YouTube will tell you how to program a motor, but it won't tell you how to control it with a joystick. So that was a totally new experience, and once I figured it out, I was super happy. Seeing it run and like actually seeing it go through the hoops and obstacle course just as planned, and having it do better than we thought it would do, it was just really awesome how it all came together.
One of the accomplishments was probably our obstacle course. We hit a 414, and our second round we hit a 256.
We learned hydrodynamics, very, very important. Buoyancy is very, very key. We've learned how to make your motors faster, measuring and 3D designing, all in Fusion 360. It was a lot of testing and improving the whole process, yeah. This amazing thing we can get to do and learn and build this ROV that we can operate ourselves. We actually got 34 seconds on the obstacle course, which is right now a state record. And we are very, very proud of that. It's 3 seconds slower than the world record. So we are very, very proud.
Engineering and science and STEM is something that's severely overlooked in the agriculture industry. Even not using this as an engineer, but applying these principles to agriculture and then going home and like, well, this didn't work this time, so let's try something else. I think this really shows that you gotta keep working and you gotta persevere. And so I think the biggest part of the engineering that we've learned is to keep going. I mean, keep going.